Hello, my lovely leather ladies and lads. Am I live? I almost said ladies and live. Am I live? Skip the lads. No, the lads are hello as well. You're welcome. Everyone's welcome. Big night tonight. I hope everybody's jumping on. We've got a drawing. Woohoo! I know how much Facebook doesn't like it because of spam artists, and I'm hardly a spam artist. I'm only a leather artist. But I do believe in being generous, especially like it's our birthday. I know it's backwards for you guys, so just, you know, go look at it in the mirror, okay? But happy birthday. So it's our birthday, and, you know, I want to be generous because the way social media is designed, we can't, small businesses, meaning me and other small businesses, can't actually run our businesses nowadays without our customers supporting us and sharing us. And so, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Look at how sweet she is. Are you suddenly going to be needy? You're going to be needy. That's okay. You be needy until people get on. And then we're going to have to have you sit like a good girl next to us, huh? So those of you who are watching on the replay and seeing this, she's just being a sweet little doll tonight. So a little on the colder side here in New York. I'm wearing 3/4 length sleeves. She's wearing a lighter sweat little shirt. Not even a dress, just a shirt with little elephants on it. Pink elephants and sloths and giraffes and ducks. She's quite the baby. Are you mama's baby? Yeah. Oh, she's breathing heavy. She's ready to go to sleep. So, waiting for everyone to get on. Got this gorgeous pair of earrings I want to give away. I want to show you some of the new earrings that I have featured this week because I am releasing new earrings this week. On top of everything else we're doing this week, we should talk about the Mother's Day roses because there's a couple left. They're going pretty quick. And we should also talk about Star Wars Day, which is just a couple days away, May the 4th, in case you didn't know. If you try to celebrate it on the 5th, you're either a Sith or Sith. Can't ever say that right. You're either a Sith or you're a stormtrooper and you aimed for the 4th and missed. Which is always one of my favorite jokes. I think it's funny every single time. So I'm waiting for everybody to jump on. I just thought I'd take a moment to promote my new book. That's right. I wrote a book. Technically, that makes me a leader in the field because not many leather jewelry designers have written books. I did not write on leather jewelry designing. I wrote on how to take care of your leather and metal jewelry components. Something you can apply to all of the jewelry in your jewelry box and your leather jacket, your leather skirt, your leather boots, your leather couch, your leather seats in your car, how to identify the leathers, what types of care they each require. It's a tiny little book because it's really just a guide. It's not going to give you all the deep, crazy stuff that's going to be like overwhelming. You're not, you need some, that kind of level of clean. I really strongly recommend having it professionally done. And always check with your manufacturer warranty. Check with your manufacturer's directions or your artist designer's directions. Make sure that those are followed because they know best for that specific piece. Yeah, actually, different cuts of leather, like if I'm cutting from the center back versus if I'm cutting from the underarm, there really is different care because some are stretchy and some are not. Some are more resilient. So even on each piece, the care specifics do change quite a bit. Yes, when you order from me, there is on my website this journal. There's a lot of articles on the journal, so go there and check out the journal. If you like how I read or how I write my style, they're all short, little 1-minute reads or less. But I do have care instructions there for your earring specific. And they're still very general. It really, this gives you better instructions on how to take care of it. So my copy says not for resale. Yours will not have this band across it. So where is everybody? Maybe I need to like tag a few people. I know Carrie said she was coming on. So let's tag her. And let's tag Becky. Becky, who understands that if you have a drawing that says unlimited entries, enter lots of times. Becky is almost 50% of the entries. So that's kind of crazy. There's a strong probability she's going to win. Who else is on the list? Maybe I can tag them too. Let's see. Rebecca. Of course, if I spell it right, it'll come up. So Todd Schumann entered. I don't know if he'll come on. So we do have a gentleman who's entered to win. I know that he's bought earrings before for his family members, which is super sweet. Thank you for the support if he watches in the replay. We have Becky, we have Rebecca, we have Becky. We have Kristen Martin, who I'm not friends with. Jackie Polito, I think I was pronouncing that right, not friends with. Jerry is not on Facebook. Becky again. Elizabeth. Christy. Elizabeth Christy, there she is. And Mary Chapin. Audrey, let's see if we can get Audrey on tonight. She usually misses it because she's coming home from work. She's out almost to the West Coast in Texas. So her time is an hour or so behind us. I'm not sure exactly which. My aunt entered. So let's put her in. That's Susan. And, oh, Tracy entered. So let's see if we can get Tracy on here tonight. There we go. Those are the people who entered. On the official post, I did post the official spreadsheet so people could find their names and what number is assigned to them. So when we do the drawing and we see what number, they can see what number is them. And they'll be like, hey, that's my number. I won. Yay. So I put that out there. And trying to think who else usually joins us. I know Sonnet usually joins us, but she's been very busy and not on Facebook, but we'll tag her anyway. Who else can we tag? I think that's everybody. Oh, I know Jennifer was going to try to catch it, but she wasn't sure because her daughter's recently joined softball, spring softball, which is nice. Okay, I've tagged y'all. Where you at? I did what I could. You know, I made the calendar appointment. I did the thing on Facebook. If you're watching on YouTube and Rumble, everybody's over on Facebook. So sorry, you know, they get all the attention because that's where everybody is. Someday they will all leave Facebook and, you know, maybe we'll all join on YouTube. So I'm just going to get started then. I'll start showing the new earrings. We have lots of new earrings this week. 7 pair, actually. And not all exactly the same, which is fun because you don't always necessarily want them all the same. Besides, I was restocking some of the ones that we were lower on. And since 1, 2, and 3 inch sell the most, I'm always restocking the 1, 2, 3 inch. So this is another run of 1, 2, 3 inch. These ones. This beautiful army green. I believe they're called Battle Shield because of that. I'm trying to find a nice army sounding name without saying something like making a name that couldn't be said on social media. You know how social media feels about anything militant. Let me grab my poker, a little pointer there. So these have this beautiful green bead right here, a little glass seed bead underneath holding it in place. This green leather is a suede back, and this black goat leather. Mm-hmm. Ta-da! Has a suede back as well. So now you can see the suede back and the suede back. So very, very nice quality leathers, and I just twisted this. So if these get twisted in the mail or twisted in your jewelry box, just be gentle with them. Relax it a little and it will come back to where it needs to be. So there they are. These are the 1-inch, which are absolutely, you know, darling, sweet, fun, just as fun as the larger ones, but made in a smaller size for those of you who want to wear them to work, who want to wear them every day to like the office, to dinners, to things like that, where things are a little calmer. 2-inch are also very popular and safe for work. You get bigger than that, and you know, there's always that one girl in the office who does wear statement jewelry to work, and you gotta love her. But everybody seems to think she's got a whole lot of bravado and she's very brave, but a little boldness doesn't hurt nobody. And it doesn't really take boldness to wear these. What it takes is an appreciation for fine art. Here's another one that I've got twisted because I have these laying here. So I may actually not be able to show you this pair because it's twisted pretty bad here. Oh, there, nope. There we go. There we go. It was twisted pretty bad, but I got it. I got it. I got it. I got it. So here's the 2-inch. There we have it. So there's the 2-inch. I just showed the 1-inch and the 2-inch. So again, 2 inches are most popular size. As you can see, it's subtle, but it still makes a little bit of a statement. It's very normal for work and play. And remember, when these go into your ears, they go back at a slight angle. They're not facing straight forward. Like you can see mine, they're at an angle. They're not straight forward. When I used to wear those long pigtails, they always went straight forward. So it looks very big and bold, but they're not. They're nice and subtle. And so there you have the 2-inch. Let's bring up the 3-inch. I thought I saw Jennifer pop on and then she popped off. She didn't say hi. The way Facebook works is it only occasionally shows me who's on. It doesn't always. So if you jump on, always say hi so I know you're here, because it doesn't always show me when people are here. And so that's not fun. So here's the 3-inch. Again, the same leathers, the same cut, the same style. Obviously not exactly the same because they're all hand cut, hand painted. It's a different bead as well, and it has 2 seed beads. Actually, that is a, get my face out of the way, that is a cut crystally golden, can you see that? That is an actual like cut golden, beautiful, beautiful bead. It's kind of subtle and it doesn't really stand out on its own. So I put it with other things, but really wish it would stand out on its own because it's just absolutely beautiful. Did I show you the beads on the 2-inch? I'm starting to wonder if I'm being suppressed on Facebook because I just don't seem to get any people here anymore. So the 2-inch also has a tiny, beautiful cut bead like the 3-inch. And it doesn't have a seed bead at all. It has that beautiful green glass bead. Absolutely stunning pieces, if I do say so myself. But I'm, you know, I just throw beautiful things together and I'm surprised myself at how they turn out. So, you know, when you're doing these things, you kind of get surprised on your own how they turn out. So next up, we have these beautiful butterfly wings. Couldn't think of the insect. They're beautiful butterfly wings. They're a resin butterfly wing charm. And I have this beautiful pink and gold and gray with this platinum gold piece of pigskin. Look at that. The back of it is, look at that, the same colors. And this gorgeous blue leather. That's beautiful suede on the back, a low nap suede, not a heavy nap, which I don't have a lot of low nap suedes. It actually made me want to paint on the suede side of it, which I might do for another pair coming up. We'll see, because it really has a nice low nap, and that would hold paint very well. So that's kind of exciting to me. I like things that hold paint well. Next up, I have some Southwestern. I have a frog in my throat. Let's first get rid of the frog. Tonight's tea is nettle tea. What tea are you drinking? Like tea? I like tea. Okay. All right. I think I got the frog gone. It was a tickle, actually. So I have these 2-inch Southwestern pair and another 2-inch Southwestern pair made from the same pattern. It is a yellow leather and golden color yellow. It's not suede like the buckskin that you're used to seeing. And this has this beautiful tooling and dye work. So yeah, that's actually embossed. It's an embossed style tooling and some dye work. And then there's this teal green that is just tucked into all of the little corners. That's called antiquing when the green gets into the corners like that. It's actually the type of paint. It's actually the style. And then the antiquing all the way around the edge to really bring that teal out. The back is a beautiful silver. It's got a clamp bail. So as you can see, the bail is a clamp, which is what causes this folded on top. Very sculptural. Love the sculpted edge of it. Love how it came out. So, yep, we have this 2-inch Southwestern pair right here. And so that's new this week. And then the last new pair that's ready for this week, and again, after we do this, we'll talk about the Mother's Day, then we'll talk about the giveaway, and then a sneak peek at the new pairs for Star Wars Day. So here is the last of the new pairs for this week. Another 2-inch made of the same leather as the last one. It's got this beautiful metal stud. It's got a stud. Aren't you studly? So this big stud too. I mean, that's not tiny. That's big. So this is a little bit on the edgier side, but definitely still Southwestern, rock and roll. You can have a lot of fun with this. Even bringing this to like music festival seasons is upon us. So even music festivals and stuff. So again, it's got this beautiful tooled pattern with the teal just antiqued in there. And teal around the edges again. And this time the teal is also on the back. Yes, the stud is pressed through and folded on the back. Don't worry, that won't poke you. That won't hurt you. Unless you want to poke at it and prick at it and pull it off, then it's going to hurt you. So I don't recommend that, obviously, because it is glued. It's not just clipped on like that. There's glue there. So these are absolutely, actually, these would go very well with this outfit, wouldn't it? I like it. I should make something similar for myself with this one. So there we have all the new earrings. and a frog still in my throat. And here is the pair that we are giving away today for our birthday. Happy birthday! Yay! So, can you believe it's been 2 years of you guys just coming to all these lives every single week? So anyway, here's the 2-inch. We will do that drawing in just a moment. It's 8:50. I want to hurry this up and get moving along. So, for Mother's Day, don't forget to get your orders in by the 8th because we need to mail them on time unless you're going to do like the 2-day service. But sometimes the 2-day service takes 3 days to get there. So the sooner you order them, the better. Not to mention, these are going really quick. The tan brown one already sold. The purple one already sold. It's right here. It's going out the door. In a day or two. I forget which day I have it on the calendar to go. The blue ones are still available. I know Sonnet wants them, but she hasn't ordered them yet. But they're still available. Teal one. Now, guys, where's my pointer? This teal one is absolutely gorgeous. It has this tealish silver pearl, and then that same silvery all the way around every single leaf. Absolutely stunning. I love the color of this cute little leaf sticking up. Look at that. Right? It's got the light. The stem is just a little coil. It's kind of fun and cute. That they do come with a little pin, so you just pin them on, and or you can just leave them on your table. If you have a bud vase, you can straighten that coil out and put it in a bud vase. Works as well. I know that some people have put them in bud vases, keeping it next to your bed. I know lots of people just love to smell the leather. The only thing better than smelling roses is smelling leather. So, you know, stop and smell these flowers because they all smell like leather. And then, of course, the one I was at doing most of the advertising with is this cute pink one with this cut sparkly bead in there. It's a foggy pink, gorgeous, a different color green shine there. The coily stem. And I hand painted little tiny flowers all around this little thing. So it's got this cute little detail of these little flowers and a little hint of sparkle here and there. So along the tip edge of things, you'll see little hints of sparkle. Absolutely stunning. This pink suede is sun touched. I laid it where the sun was able to get it. I didn't mean to. And I thought, oh, it's ruined forever, but it's not, because look at how beautiful the lighter colors that the sun bleached with the darker colors and the lighter colors just look. Absolutely beautiful, stunning. So that one is still available. And this one, it's a little sheepskin suede. It is soft. It is lightweight, super thin, very delicate. And it looks like an antiqued red rose to begin with. Like, you know how it starts to turn brown a little bit? This one is just naturally colored with the browns and the burgundies, and it's just beautiful. I put this gorgeous little hearts all over it, this stunning pearl center. I just absolutely love the way this one came out. It's very delicate, beautiful, has a darker green back with a darker green leaf, and I think your mothers will be very happy with this. And if not your mothers, you can get it for yourself. And if you don't, I'm going to take that little pin and I'm going to pin it right here and I'm going to wear it. It actually will look really good there. So let's get on that. Okay, so those are all the things I have for today, except for the intro to Star Wars Day, which is going to be Thursday. So Thursday I am going live at 8:30. And we're gonna launch the Star Wars things. I do it every year on the 4th. And may the 4th be with you. They sell out real quick, so I hope you guys are prepared and ready to catch it. Squirrel! Don't forget I sell squirrels and other stickers. And let's get into the drawing. Drum roll, please. So on the official drawing post on Facebook, there was also a way to enter on Instagram, and there was a way to enter on the website. So I put on there where everybody entered. If you entered on Facebook, it's FB, Instagram, IG, website. I just wrote out website. And we have a good number of entries. And so 18 entries. Again, Becky has a heavy lot of them. So we will see. I'm again going to draw two names. I'm going to grab a pen. Got a pen? So we're going to draw two names, because if for some reason the winner doesn't want it, I have the second name. And I have people's email addresses or Facebooks to connect with them. So we're going to do it. I went to random.com. So the random dot, it's not google.random, it's .com/. It's the random number generator on Google. I've already entered. I'm trying to get it to connect to the Wi-Fi. I'm struggling here with, bear with me. Oh, the Wi-Fi's turned off. That's why. I'm sorry about that. You're right, I think I have everything like attached and ready and okay, there we go. So it's going to be backwards to you because that's what it is. But here it is, the random number generator on Google. I've already entered 1 is the minimum number, and 18 is the maximum number. And then you hit this button. This isn't the thing, but it shows you over here that there's a number drawn. So we're going to do this a few times to try to. This is a touch screen, so you can see every time it changes. So we're going to do this a few times to try to clear it. Okay, now we're going to. You can see my ring light. There's my ring light. Hi, ring. Which isn't very bright today unless I'm like right here. I don't have it aimed correctly, I think. Anyway, we're going to do the official right now. So this is for the winner, not the runner-up, the winner. Here we go. Generate. May I look? It's number one. Number one is the winner. Ding 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 ding. So that would be Todd Schumann. Todd Schumann is the winner. Congratulations, Todd. Now, just in case, because he's not on to accept it, he doesn't want it for any reason, or if he wants to pass it on to the runner-up, we're going to do the runner-up right now. So here we go, the official runner-up post. I'm going to touch it. Okay. And number four is the runner-up. So number four is Rebecca. You are the runner up. Congratulations on being the runner up. Let's hope that Todd doesn't want it if you really do. So there you have it, folks. There is the official drawing. So woohoo! Let's get back over to the page. I'm going to put that in here. Okay, computer's still slow. There we have it. So, and Elizabeth joined us. Hey, welcome. Did you catch the drawing? Because I was so busy doing the drawing, I didn't see you even joined us. Thank you for the happy birthday. I appreciate it. It's unbelievable to have been doing this for 2 years, and of course that's with all the help from you guys. You also missed me showing the new earrings from this week, so you're gonna have to just watch Facebook to see them. And we did the drawing. Todd Schumann is the winner. The runner-up is Rebecca. And so if he doesn't want it for some reason, it goes to her. And that's not all. So don't leave. Don't jump off. Because I just want to remind you that the Mother's Day roses are still available. Got a few colors left that are absolutely stunning and definitely smell like leather. So that's fantastic. And don't forget about the book. Okay, that's enough plugs for me. So the last thing on today is Thursday is Geek Day. I mean, it's Star Wars Day on Thursday. So May the 4th. So May the 4th be with you. So I thought I would give people a little sneak peek at some of this year's Star Wars ones. When I started the business, we, because you guys helped, it was April 30th, and we stayed up until midnight because everybody wanted to be live with me while I switched the switch. And I didn't tend to do like a 9 to 9 o'clock until midnight live, but I did because I was convinced to by everybody, which was awesome. So anyway, we did the live and sold so many things. So I immediately had to make things, and people are like, "Are you gonna do Star Wars for Star Wars Day?" And I was like, "If you're gonna buy them, I'll make them." So I did in that week between May 30th and or April 30th and May 4th, I made Star Wars ones. I put them up there and they sold out. All of them just sold out. So the next year I was like, I'm doing this again. Is anybody interested? And everyone was like, yes. So I said, okay. And I put them out there and everything sold except for this guy. Why does everybody hate Mando? I don't know why people don't like Mando, but this all, everything sold except for Mando. So here's Mando. He's beautiful. I don't know why people didn't jump on it. Yes, the paint, the pigment is a high gloss, and it's because it's sealed. So it's beautiful. I like it. So Mando is still available. He's still around. I don't know why he's still around, but he's still around. So this year I got him a companion. So and I have the Chewbacca one still, which I forgot to put over here. That one has his utility sash thing on the key ring. It has like the utility sash down the edge. It's subtle, but it's still obviously inspired by Star Wars. So Mando now has a friend. So I made Mando a friend. So these are the ones that are coming out. They won't be on the website and released until the 4th. And I'll do a live and we'll launch it then. So it'll be 8:30 or later when they're finally launched. But we've got a couple key rings. And Grogu is in the house. Ain't he cute? A little Grogu. So then we have, because, you know, if I'm doing Star Wars again, I need to represent Yoda. And I try not to do the same thing every year. And I already did kind of like a caricature of him. So this year, I just did Yoda's lightsaber. And of course, on the littlest ones, because his lightsaber had the smaller kyber crystal to make it smaller. And I'm really showing my geek, aren't I? Side note, I am not a Disney fan. Never have been. Never, ever. Not even as a child. Didn't like Disney. They killed Bambi's mother in front of us. No, I don't like. They killed the Lion King in front of me. No, I don't like Disney. But I do like Star Wars. So this is pre-Disney Star Wars, kind of. So anyway, here's our lightsaber, kind of, as I have like this guy. I guess he's not pre-Disney. Sorry. But here's Yoda's lightsaber, and it's got the little details, and it's tiny and just absolutely adorable. It does glow. There's actually, in this paint, there's different shadows of the lime green, so it definitely glows lime green. And if I was going to have Yoda's lightsaber, I definitely need to have a little representative from the dark side. I hear they have cookies. I like cookies, so... Here we go. We have Darth Vader's lightsaber. And yes, you know how his lightsaber, well, maybe you don't, but his lightsaber has like a little angle on it. So this has got the little angle on it right here and the little clip thing that's on his. And so that's, oh, there we go. Do it this way and you can't see the glare from the ceiling. So isn't that gorgeous? And the best part is, you could wear these and not let anybody know that it's Star Wars. And anybody who does know Star Wars would be like, that's a lightsaber. But otherwise, it's just a beautiful black and red piece of jewelry, which is just awesome. Okay. Of course, I'm saving the best for last. So here are three of the best in no particular order because they're all absolutely fantastic, awesome. My favorite character has always been R2. Now, I love stormtroopers, don't get me wrong. There's just something fun about them and how goofy they always miss everything. And I think it's more the storyline with stormtroopers. It's a different level of nostalgia where R2 is the character that I absolutely love. So here's my R2. And hold it at that angle again. So you can see beautiful silver and he's got the details and the, see, everybody loves R2. Isn't he awesome? And now that I showed you that one, I have to show you the other one because they are different. because I am not a photocopy machine. So here we go. And this, of course, shows the other part of him where it's even got the little thingy on the top and the little eyeball here. And the other big eyeball that you're used to seeing is over here, which is prevalent on this one. So you can see that there are two different sides of him. And R2 fans and people. I'm good friends with a droid builder. Yes, there's people who build Star Wars droids. And his R2 is just absolutely, I always refer to him as R2's dad. My friend, R2's dad. So there's R2. And then if I have R2, you know you gotta have this guy. The lesser loved, but absolutely still iconic and well-loved character, 3CPO. I almost said C-3PO. Wait, 3C-3. Oh, jeez. It's not fun to be dyslexic. Anyway, here's this rusty can of bolts. C-3PO, thank you. So here he is. Look at this. And two parts in his classic arm out, the other one across the front of him. Yes, one of his legs, get my face out of the way so it focuses. One of his legs is definitely silver. You can tell I'm a little on the old school side, right? So he's got the silver leg. The gold for this is actually done with gold foil leaf. So this is gold foil leafed. Absolutely fantastic. If you, I do say so myself, which I do say so. So there. So this is your sneak peek on what's coming on Thursday. So come back Thursday night at 8:30 and I will do a live and we'll launch these into the world. This is just a sneak peek, just kind of on the down low. And last but not least, I hear this lovely lady, Ahsoka Tana, right? Tana is the last part. Ahsoka is having her own show coming up. August? Is that right? August? I don't know, because I'm not a Disney watcher, and I don't have Disney Plus, and I'm not watching it, because I don't like Disney. Yes, Disney hurt me. Should have never killed Bambi's mom. So anyway, my goodness, am I showing my age? So anyway, as you can see, it's the white face paint, just like in the Clone Wars where the clones all painted their helmets for her face paint. I decided just to do her face paint. And so it's just her face paint and then her hair in the silver and black, because on the show poster, it looks silver and black. So I tried to do the silver and black just like the show poster. So there you have it. I anticipate these are going to sell fast. I really do. I think that I'll be sold out again. I tried to make a couple more. I've got a BB over here. I've got another one. But unfortunately, I just did not have the time to finish them, get them photographed, uploaded, ready for this week. So, womp womp. Sorry. This actually is, though, the largest number I've created for a Star Wars collection launch. So usually I just keep it really tiny and just good luck. May the force be with you to get them because they're going to be going quick. So that's it for tonight, folks. I'm going to throw this over to YouTube and Rumble and say hi to them. And Star Wars, be back on Facebook Live Thursday night. 8:30. We'll talk about these more. I'll tell you what they're made of. I can tell you more about the process with them. We'll go into details and I will launch them, make them live so you can buy it. So have your credit cards handy. We're also thinking about maybe taking one of them and doing a fundraiser. I just have to get more details on somebody who is in need and could use some money. So I'm looking into that. And so there we have it. Oh, and it looks like Todd just jumped on. Congratulations, Todd. We did the drawing. You weren't here. But you've won the beautiful giveaway pair. Hold on. I'm going to pull them up. You have won the giveaway pair. Absolutely beautiful. Congratulations. If for some reason you don't want it, you know what? We'll message after this, okay? So we'll chat after this. If you're available, let me know if you're available to chat. So we'll chat after this and we can figure out. If you don't want it, I did draw a runner-up. So there is a runner-up ready if you don't want it. And I just dropped it. Hold on. I'm sorry. Chair won't slide now. There we go. Okay. You know, it's not a show until I drop one, right? Isn't that what always happens? Yeah, the Star Wars stuff is cool. We're going to actually show them in detail. I just did a quick show now of them, but we're going to show them in detail on Thursday and launch them. They're going to be available for purchase on Thursday. And they're shared to a couple Star Wars groups. And if you want to continue to share them to Star Wars groups, I'd appreciate it. I anticipate they'll sell out this year. Last year sold out, the year before sold out, except last year this guy didn't sell out. And I don't know why this guy is still here for a year later, because he's awesome. I mean, I don't know what people have against Mando. But Mando's still here. Maybe it's because I kind of gave him a Boba Fett reference for a name. But Mando's still here. And this year I gave him a little partner. So maybe both of them can find homes this year. Okay, that's all I got. We're going to throw this over to YouTube and Rumble. Todd, message me. Let me know if you're available for a phone call. I'll give you a call as soon as I've got this loaded over there. That's it. I'll see everybody Thursday. Bye.